Hello friends, I am Maumita Rai Hajra from AM Liz, a place where you can get all relevant information and knowledge regarding library and information science. We debate the topic recent trends in library cataloging from ancient time to 21st century in two parts. Part 1 will cover the following topics: AACR, ISBT, OPAC, Cataloging Network, RGA. And the part 2 will cover FRBR, FRAD, FRSAD, BibFrame, FRBRW. PDF link of the topic will be shared in the description box of part 2 videos. Kindly watch this. So friends, watch this video till the end, and if you enjoy it, kindly give me like and share this video to your friends. Don't forget to subscribe my channel Emily's and press bell button to get notification for next videos. From the previous video, recent trends in library cataloging part 1, we have learned about the meaning and the history of library cataloging. We have known where from and when AACR and ISBT emerged and how they work. We have discussed the 9 areas of ISBT. We have focused on the significance of OPAC and its major components. From this video, the important parts of OCLC, ARLIN, WLN have been covered. Last but not the least, the causes behind the emergence of RDA has been revealed, and the features of RDA are also discussed. Now, in this video, recent trends in library cataloging part 2 will be discussed. So friends, let's start. FRBR, Functional and Requirements for Bibliographic Records. From 1992 to 1995, the IFLA, International Federation of Library Associations and Institutions, Study Group on Functional Requirements and for Bibliographic Records, FRBR, developed an entity relationship model. It represents a more holistic approach to retrieval and access as the relationships between the entities. FRBR comprises group of entities. Group 1. These entities are defined as the products of intellectual or artistic endeavors that are named or described in bibliographic records. Work, which is a distinct intellectual or artistic creation. Expression, which is the specific intellectual or artistic form that a work takes each time it is realized. Manifestation, which is the physical embodiment of an expression of a work. Item, which is a single exemplar of a manifestation. The entity defined as item is a concrete entity. Group 2. These entities are person and corporate body that are related to Group 1 entities through specific relationships. These entities are responsible for the intellectual or artistic content. Group 3. These entities represent an additional set of entities that serve as the subjects of work. These are concept, object, event, and place. Relationships. According to FRBR, relationships serve as the vehicle for depicting the link between one entity and another, and thus as the means of assisting user to navigate the universe that is represented in a bibliographic catalog or bibliographic database. Equivalence relationships. Equivalence relationships exist between exact copies of the same manifestation of a work or between an original item and reproductions of it. Examples include reproductions such as copies, issues, facsimiles, and reprints photocopies and microfilms. Derivative relationship. Derivative relationship exists between a bibliographic work and a modification based on the work. Examples include editions, versions, translations, summaries, abstracts, adaptations, and became new work but are based on old works. New works based on the style or the thematic content of the work. Descriptive relationship. Descriptive relationship exists between a bibliographic entity and a description, criticism, evaluation, or review of that entity, such as between a work and a book review describing it. To get online support and guidance to crack UGC, NTA, NET, SET, JRF, KBS, WBSSC librarian and all type of competitive exams in the field of librarian information science, you should join AIMLIS online coaching classes. Our WhatsApp number is 9163-442987 and email ID is momita.aimlis21@gmail.com. AIMLIS will provide you 4,000 plus objective questions with answers, theory notes based on syllabus, live classes with video recording, free demo classes, mock tests, previous year's questions with answers, practice sets, and interview tips. FRAD and FRSAD. Two working group was formed during 1999 to 2009 by IFLA. The working group of functional requirements and numbering of authority records, FRANAR, was established in April 1999. The IFLA working group on the functional requirements for subject authority records, FRSAR, was formed in 2005. The FRSAR working group 2005 to present and the FRANAR working group 1999 to 2009 both worked in parallel to develop models within the FRBR framework. By the time FRANAR released its final report named as Functional Requirement for Authority Data, FRAD, formally known as Functional Requirements for Authority Records, FRAR, which is a conceptual entity relationship model. This model focuses on four important tasks. 1. Find an entity or set of entities corresponding to stated criteria. 2. Identity an entity. 3. Contextualize. Place a person, corporate body, work, etc. in context and justify. Choosing the name or form of name on which an access point is based. FRSAD. FRSAR also released its first draft report of the functional requirements for subject authority data, FRSAD, for worldwide review. The conceptual model of FRSADR: work, thema, and nomen. Work is a distinct intellectual or artistic creation. Thema is anything that can be the subject of a work. This is the abstract idea of the aboutness of a given work. Thema is independent of language and disciplines. Nomen, any alphanumeric, sound, visual, or any other symbol sign or combination of symbols by which a theme is known, referred to or addressed. BIPFRAM, Bibliographic Framework. In 2011, the Library of Congress began a project to end libraries' isolation from the semantic web called BIPFRAM. BIPFRAM framework as a successor to the MARC formats is a data model for bibliographic description. BIPFRAM is expressed in RDF, Resource Description Framework, and based on the three categories of abstraction such as work, instance, item, with three additional classes, agent, subject, and event, that relate to the core categories. The Library of Congress released version 2.0 of BIPFRAM in 2016. The National Library of Sweden was the first national library to fully transition to BIPFRAM in 2018. FRBRW, FRBR Object Oriented. The first draft of FRBRW was completed in 2006. The model expresses the attributes and relationships in the entity relationship model of FRBR, formulated as an extension of the CIDOC CRM. Version 2.4 of FRBRW model was released in November 2015. So friends, I hope this video is very fruitful for all of you. To get more videos and information regarding library and information science, kindly like and subscribe the channel. If you have any queries, please say on comment box and share this video to your friends. Before ending my video, friends, all of you can connect with me through these following links.